Turn It Up. You're listening to Live and Loud with the Lord, Nelson, that is.
Ladies and gentlemen, you know who it is. It is yours truly, the Lord. Nelson, that is, man. Yo, I got a new thing going on, man. I want you guys to hop on in my car right now. Take a ride with me, right? My car, the C.A.R. Classic Album Review. And of course, you can see who I'm going to review right now. Yo, I'm going to start off this series with Michael Jackson, his first album, Off the Wall. Now, listen, I was a little bit younger during that time, and I probably didn't understand everything that was going on then. You know, my parents and my older sisters and brother, they were really rocking it. But listen, I was rocking it too, man, because I'm a lover of music. So what I want to do is take the time to go through these classic albums to see what made them classic albums and, you know, why they're so great. Because a lot of times, man, we're time machined by this music. But if you go back and listen to it, you'll find out so many things. You'll see how many people have sampled or did these songs by these great. And listen, I'm just going to get started. We're not going to take a long time. I just want to run through those tracks, and I want to talk about them. I wish we could play all the music while we're doing it, you know, but YouTube and everything, they'll strike you. But what I want to do is, after I have had conversation about these songs, I want to inspire you to go back and listen to these albums. Go back and listen to this music. I'm going to do all genres, of course. But we're going to start off with Miguel Jacksono. Yeah, Mike was an amazing dude, man, no doubt. So let's get started. So Off the Wall by Michael Jackson, August 10th, 1979, the release. And it's a mix of disco, R&B, funk, pop, you know, and ballads. You got a couple ballads on there, no doubt. So produced by Quincy Jones. How can you go wrong with Quincy Jones? You can't. It's impossible. You feel me? So lyrics by Stevie Wonder, Paul McCartney, Rod Temperton, and David Foster also. So these are big names, big musicians who write unbelievable songs and have written amazing songs for so many other artists. Yes, indeed. So Michael now wrote three, actually, of the songs. Let's see here. He wrote Don't Stop Till You Get Enough. Come on, come on, come on. Working Day and Night. Woo! And Get on the Floor with Louis Johnson. Michael. Did I say Michael Jordan? No, I just said Mike, man. He's great too. Anyway, man, I won't lose my train of thought. So, first song, Don't Stop Until You Get Enough. Don't Stop Till You Get Enough. Let's say it correctly. The intro to me is so awesome. Mike hit us with that player talk. So, you know, I had to get it right. So, this is how Mike did it. Let me get it right. He said, you know, I was wondering, you know, if you could keep on, because the force, it's got a lot of power. You know, you make me feel like, yeah, I ain't hit that right, but yo, Michael's a wild dude, right? So if you've seen the video, you know, Mike is really feeling this, you know. Let's keep it real though. How many of us really didn't know what he was saying? Because, you know, some of those words, we might not have known what he was saying, but sounded amazing, right? Still to this day, you guys are singing the wrong words. You're singing the wrong words. Go look at the lyrics. Get yourself right. You'll feel better. Guaranteed. Mike Jackson, yeah, Don't Stop Till You Get Enough. Number two, Rock With You.
Girl, close your eyes. Let that rhythm get in.
Now, this is one of my favorites on the album. The video with the fog lights and the shiny space suit and boots. You see it right there. I mean, there you go right there. I got that one up. Because look at Mike. Look at him. And then the big thing about it was the early days of the Jerry Curl. So, like, what did Cedric the Entertainer say? Like Luther Vandross had, like, that curl that just wasn't quite. It just...
I like big curl ain't quite right, Luther. That's the one I like. That boy made all that money in his curl. Never. His curl never really, never curled all the way over.
those were the early days of that Jerry curl, man. It wasn't totally curled out like it should be, but they were working on it, man. They were getting it right. They were getting it right. Look, Mike looks so happy, man. That man thin, though. That man weighed about 115 pounds, though. But, man, he's one of the greatest. So, we got what? Working day and night. Yo, man. So it just hits you immediately and makes you move, right? I don't know if people understand how incredible the music is and how talented the musicians are and the unbelievable orchestration, yo, that accompanies his lyrics. Yo, great ad-libs, too. You know, Mike's in the back, you know, doing all what he does, man. Mike might have been the king of ad-libs. I thought it was Jim Jones, but it might be Michael Jackson, man. Mike had them ad-libs, man. It was on point. So Mike is like, you know, how can I love you properly when I'm always working day and night? It's a great question. How can I love you properly if I'm always working? Could you be getting your love from somebody else? Mike was asking those questions, man. You know, as a young kid, I wouldn't pay no attention to that, man. But, you know, your parents knew what was up, man. You know what I'm saying? But I'm tired. And for all this work, I'm not getting enough love from you. That's all that Mike was saying. He's just like, yo, you gotta do better. You know better, so do better. Ladies or gentlemen, whoever it is, you working hard like that, get your man or your woman, get right. Love your mate. Do the right thing, for real. So, the next song, Get on the Floor, it's just to get him, it's just a good feeling song. So it's a great listen with a great groove. The chorus is what stands out to me, though. I love the chorus. I don't want to go into singing it, even though, man, my voice is stellar. Not for Michael Jackson, but, yo, it's a great song, and that bass line is so dope. And Mike just wants to dance. The song is all about just getting out there and having a good time and dancing. So now, Off the Wall. Off the Wall. And you know, I got to just kind of pause when I'm saying that. Off the Wall, ladies and gentlemen. It's definitely my favorite off the album. The title track, Time Machines, the you-know-what out of me, back to Fort Jackson. Every time I hear it, stays in constant rotation. It brings back unbelievable memories of being a child. And once again, really not understanding these grown-ass lyrics your parents are singing with Mike, you know. But I understand them clearly now. I do, man. Come on, man. Off the Wall is an amazing song. Ladies and gentlemen, in fact, when you go listen to this album, go listen to Off the Wall first. Go listen to that one first when you go listen to this album. You got to do it, man. What a great song. So. Girlfriend. Yo, man, look, I got my notes, man, because, you know, I want to make sure everything's right. But let's talk about this girlfriend. Mike is tripping, yo. Mike is messing with this dude's girl, right? Mike gets in his feelings, so he wants to tell the dude, I'm smashing your chick, yo.
Girlfriend, I'm gonna tell you, boy.
Mike wants to be that dude. First of all, you shouldn't be doing dirt anyway, okay? Let's just say it. Be loyal. Don't do dirt. Mike was like, yo, I'm smashing your girl. And I want to tell you because I want her all to myself. But then I'm thinking, if she's still going back to him, Mike, she's enjoying this more than you are. She's enjoying both sides. Maybe she's like, she gets a certain thing from you, then she gets something from him. Maybe she likes the way you sing to her. don't know, Mike. But you wrong for that, bro. Yo, man, I got double love for you, man, but you wrong for that one, Mike, man. How you going through that, man? How you going to want to tell that man you back at this girl, man? You're a wild dude, Mike. Easy, bro. Easy. So, yo, now, she's out of my life. She's out of my life. And I don't know whether to... Man, listen, I only sound crazy like that because it's the pollen, man. I thought I could hit it, but nah. I couldn't hit that, but anyway, those violins to start this song off, man, it sets you up for something emotional.
She's out of my life. She's out of my life. And I don't know whether to laugh or cry.
So Mike was hurting in this one, right? He got in his feelings for this song, and like he was living the words, and you know, just sitting on the chair, that stool, and just singing, man, and just, it was emotional, man. But it was a beautiful thing, man. So it's a beautiful song, and you know, that video really is just focused on him singing and in pain. He did a great job of bringing those lyrics out with that amazing voice of his and amazing tone. He's just one of the greatest, man. So, but now I will say that Jerry Curl, it was getting stronger. The Jerry Curl was getting closer to curling up right. I just picture Cedric the Entertainer saying it just wasn't quite, No, and listen, if I'm not mistaken, Mike had the Jerry Curl, not a Carefree Curl, not an S Curl, not a Soul Glow. Let y'all. He had none of that. Mike had the original Jerry Curl, man. So, yo, man, they finally got it right? In the later years, we know because his hair was... on another level, man. So now, let's move into track 8 of the album. And we're talking about the song, I Can't Help It.
Looking in my mirror took me by surprise. I can't help but see you running often through my mind.
Man, this song is blessed with intoxicating music, and Mike rides the rhythm so beautifully, man. He's just in that pocket, man. That's one thing about him, man. That music, he became a part of the music. That's what made him so great. He was a part of the music. Not everybody can ride the rhythms and enjoy that music and sing. Just, man, amazing. Mike was just amazing. We all know this. There's no doubt about it. So his voice was made for this song, And I know that De La Soul sampled this for Break a Dawn, Break a Dawn.
A one, two.
Break a Dawn, Break a Dawn.
A one, two.
One of my favorite, love De La Soul. Rest in peace, Dave. Love De La Soul, man. One of my favorite groups of all time. And then the group Sage, S-A-J-E. But their name Sage. I remember coming across them on IG. And I think, if I'm not mistaken, they just won a Grammy. Amazing ladies, beautiful voices. They all sing together. And listen, they covered this song. And when I say they covered this song, and they killed it, man. They did so well. It's beautiful.
I can't help it. If I wanted to, I wouldn't help it. Even if I could, I can't help it. If I wanted to, I wouldn't help it. No, I can't help it. Even if I wanted to, I couldn't help it. I wouldn't help it, no.
You know, a lot of times you hear somebody cover a song, you know, it might not be up to that level of what the original was or is, but man, Sage handled business, man. You need to check them out also. It's kind of like a Manhattan Transfer type, you know, singing together, but just all beautiful women, man. It's lovely, man. Check it out. You will enjoy it. Sage. Yes, indeed. So, now, number 9 and 10. I'm not big on these songs. Michael Jackson did them, so you know they're not bad songs, but I can see why they're number 9 and 10. He probably could have put something else on there. I'm not saying I don't like the songs, man, because Mike did them and they're beautiful songs. But I probably could have done without them. you know. What is it? It's the Falling in Love, Burn This Disco Out. They're all cool, but you know. Like, I'll tell you what, it's like my homie Ron said. Ron was like, you want songs to have replay value. These two really don't have replay value, even though I can play this whole album and listen to them at the end, you know, but you want songs with replay value. All those other songs up to number 8 have amazing replay value. Quincy Jones, all the writers, Michael Jackson, all the musicians who played the parts in there. Cause you know, my man, Fran Strine, he had a documentary called Hired Guns.
Everybody in my band's an A-list player. I just don't have time for B-list guys.
Hired Gun is the best available musician. Nobody will know who he is, but he gets the gig because he's the elite player.
And I know a lot of these players, man, they're hired guns. They come in there and they do what they do. They're so talented and they can play anything. And so, you know, you might not know a lot of these people, or you may know a lot of these people, but just didn't know that they played on these songs. So Fran Strine, what's going on? Francisco Strine. Hey, yo, man, a real, real cool dude. Ghostbusters with Ray Parker Jr., Dolly Parton. He also did a documentary on her also. Great. Make sure you check those out. Francisco Strine. Fran Strine. Yes, indeed. My brother, man. I just had to shout you out, my brother. Yo, so all I'm saying is this is a great album with one of the best vocalists of all time, with top-notch production, with one of the greatest producers of all time, with some of the greatest writers of all time. There was no way this album could fail, ladies and gentlemen. No way this album could fail. I just want to say, Mike, thank you for blessing us with beautiful music, beautiful videos. You are like, truly, when they talk about videos, man, you're that guy. We can go back to see all the stuff that's done, but you really were the one that took it to another level, man. So I know that you're still feeling us, man. Your spirit is still everywhere because the music lives on. So that means you live on, man. So much love to you. Thank you for all you've done. And so, to all my old heads, you know what's up. If you haven't listened to it in a while, pick up the Off the Wall album or download it and stream it or YouTube it or whatever you need to do and enjoy yourself again, man. Let it time machine you back to when you were younger or whatever you were at that time. You were younger if you're listening to it now. So back to those times that were really great times and could have been bad times. But when you listen to this music, you're going to feel good. There's no doubt about it. And to the young heads, hey, listen to this music. It might change your life, give you a different perspective on what we were doing back then. There's nothing wrong with the music of today. I don't trip on it because it's just a different time, you know? But if you go back and listen to this music, you'll see why we felt the way we felt, why we loved the way we loved. That's, and you know, that's what we need, you know, more in this world, you know? More love, less hate. You feel me? Yo, that's my thing now. Yo, listen, more love, less hate. That's how I'm going to have to end all my shows. More love, less hate. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you once again for, you know, jumping in my car. Classic album review, Michael Jackson, Off the Wall, an amazing album. It really took him to that next level before that Thriller took him to the, you know, out of here. But once again, Off the Wall, ladies and gentlemen, make sure you check it out. Thank you for spending some time with me. It's the Lord, Nelson, that is. Do it work, baby. You guys be good. Peace. Woo.
This is Live and Loud with the Lord, Nelson, that is.